الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، كل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series concerning reading from the book Azamat al-Islam, The Greatness of Islam by Sheikh Mahmoud Mahdi al-Istanbuli. And today, inshallah, we learning more about the beauty of Islam and the greatness of Islam to increase our faith, inshallah, and to let us know that we have no other choice or better choice than Islam. And also by knowing about the greatness of Islam, this will make us to promote us and teach us that we need to give da'wah and to inform others about Islam. And in this segment today, it says that Islam harbun ala riya, that Islam is a war against showing off. Riya, that a person do a deed seeking recognition of the people, not doing it for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the opposite of ikhlas, sincerity, that which is one of the main conditions for the good deed to be accepted. For a good deed to be classified as a good deed, and for good deed to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one main condition is what? That you're doing it for the pleasure of Allah, seeking Allah's nearness, seeking Allah's pleasure. Not to be recognized by the people, not the people to admire you, not the people to praise you. So Islam came to be a war against riya, showing off. Because it is one of the forms of associating partner beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you're seeking the people pleasure, you're seeking the people recognition. You're supposed to be seeking Allah and Allah alone. So Islam, it want to get us on the track. By doing something, seeking other than Allah's pleasure, this will make you lose the reward. You don't get the reward, you don't get the credit for what you're doing. Doesn't matter how hard the work is that you're doing, how far you go, still you are not getting anything because you did not attend Allah's pleasure. And the amazing thing about this issue of that no one can see the ikhlas or the sincerity other than Allah, because it's something is in the heart. And this again to show us how important that the ibadah of the hearts, because the ibadah, some of it we do it with our limbs, like dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do it with your tongue, okay? The salah, you do it with your body, you go up and down. The tawaf, you walk around the Kaaba, things like this, okay? The sincerity and the ikhlas, it comes in the heart. So is no one else can see it other than Allah. People do something, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاءُونَ وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَعُونَ, those who do their good deed to be seen by the people. Right? And also this became a form of punishment in the day of the judgment. Why? Because that a person is committing a shirk. Committing a shirk. What you call a shirk al-khafi, the hidden shirk. Alright? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Kahf, Surah 18, verse number 110, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعْبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. That whosoever wishes for the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is certain about reviving. You're going to be revived after death. You're going to be resurrected. You're going to meet with Allah. You're going to be questioned by Allah. That you're going to be rewarded by Allah. So what you're supposed to do if you really about this? He said, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Let him or her, alright, do what? A righteous deed. عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. And not to associate with his Lord anything or anyone. Okay? So, if you really believe in the day of judgment, believe in meeting with Allah, and you're going to be questioned, you're going to be judged, you're going to be rewarded, that what you need to do, you have to have a sincerity. Why are you doing such a thing? Seeking only Allah and the reward of Allah and the nearness of Allah, not anyone or anything. Okay? وَلَا يُشْرِكْ, and not to associate a partner or anything beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah stated in Surah number 12, verse 106, وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. So somebody would say, you mean, we're talking about the mushrikeen, those who worship idols and things. No, Allah is saying, most of them believe not, except they, while they believing, they associating partner beside Allah. How a person can be a Muslim and making shirk? Seeking the acknowledgement or the reward of Allah, of the people. To be seen by mankind. Person can be making salah and now he hear people, or he want to put some money in the charity box and see the people. Now he, instead of $10, now he's going to make it $20. Okay? Person making salah and now he feels somebody watching him or somebody come in the mosque. Now he try to take his time more in the prayer or to act more devoted. Okay? This is danger. And the Prophet ﷺ called it a shirk al-khafi, a hidden shirk, creeping to the person, you understand? Like somebody sneaking in the dark, you barely can feel it. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying what? That most of them, they committing shirk while they are believing in Allah. So we have to be very careful. Also, from the beauty of Islam, that it gave a great acknowledgement, recognition to the value of Iman. Because a deed without aqidah, it doesn't go too far. A person, his reality and his value is by Iman. A person, when he believes, he will give, he will contribute, he will work hard. Okay? And his goal is Allah. Not the position, not the name, not the fame. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in Surah number 25, verse number 23, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. And we came over that what they had achieved, and we made it vanish and like a dust in the air. All this contribution and all this preaching and all this Hajj, building a mosque, building this and that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it like have no value. Something you blow it like this and it goes like ashes. Okay? It has no weight, it has no reality, it's no stability. Okay? And we have to be very careful of these things. It's not how much you're doing, is the ikhlas, the your goal, what you doing. Okay? Not that I want to be, you understand, now I'm going to be, I have to do this and that. No, now, in the new elections, you're going to put me the imam or the president of the Islamic Center. Okay? So you did so much. But it's like nothing. It went in the air like ashes. Has no reality. Because the goal was not Allah. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in surah number 9, verse number 19, أَجَعَلْتُمْ سِقَايَةَ الْحَاجِ وَعِمَارَةَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ كَمَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَجَاهَدَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَا يَسْتَوُونَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. So, giving service to the haji, the pilgrimage, the people who go to make hajj, and renovation of the holy mosque, is it equal? Service. You don't service, okay? You doing some good deed, but this is not equal to the one who believes in Allah in the day of judgment. And he striving in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says they are not equal. And Allah doesn't guide the zalimeen. You wrong yourself when you do not have the purpose and the goal that you're Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, for talking about the beauty and the greatness of Islam, that it free the worshipper, free the human being from all faults of form of worship. Because Islam, when he telling you worship Allah and obey Allah and follow the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives you the clear cut evidence about the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Spooky stuff is not acceptable in Islam. People sitting in dark rooms and closing their eyes and or making dervish dancing, and to them it is a form of ibadah, okay? It's a form of getting closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you find Islam, like people talking about Mother Nature and talking about the God Moon or the God of the lights and the God of the all these things. But Islam, when it talks about the Creator, it gives you reality and making you to see with your own eyes and touch with your own hand. Yes, you don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you see the evidence to tell you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists. Our weakness, that we are not been made in a condition that we can be able to see the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in person, if I can use the word person, okay, to see him himself. But in the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us, as a result of believing in the unseen with evidence, Allah will give us the ability that we'll be able to look at Him and see Him and enjoy looking at Him. Okay? But here in this dunya, Allah made to be unseen, but He gave us clear-cut evidence about His wujud, His existence, His oneness, His ability. He gave us all these things. And this is a lot in the Quran. We give example. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ وَأَنْزَلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ حَدَائِقَ ذَاتَ بَهْجَةٍ مَا كَانَ لَكُمْ أَنْ تُنْبِتُوا شَجَرَهَا أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَمَّنْ جَعَلَ الْأَرْضَ قَرَارًا وَجَعَلَ خِلَالَهَا أَنْهَارًا وَجَعَلَ لَهَا رَوَاسِي وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ حَاجِزًا أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. You found a lot of verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questioning us and telling us, is the one who created the heaven and the earth, the one who had caused the rain to come down from the heaven or the sky, and it caused the vegetation to come out, okay? Is there a God beside Allah? Is there anyone else who did this? So Allah telling us about things that we see with our own eyes. And He saying, I am the one who did it. Do you have evidence? Does He have anyone other than me did it? Can anybody claim it? Until today, we don't have anybody can claim that He makes the rain come down, or that He say, I am the creator of the heaven and the earth. The only one making this claim is Allah. So you found some keys in the mosque, okay? The only one is saying is mine, only one person. You have 50 people sitting, but nobody say, I lost the keys, or this my keys. So the only one is saying, I'm doing this, and no one else standing for a challenge is Allah. Okay? Do we see the rain? Do we see the sky? Do we see the earth? Do you see the plants coming off the ground? There's no computer ships, you understand, under the dirt. How is this roots going down, and how is the branch go up, and how is the leaves, you understand? Subhanallah. Allah say, I am the one who made this. We don't have anybody else claiming it. Not as an individual, not as a collective, not as a society. Not as a government. The only one say, I did this is Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one say, I am the one who made the earth to be stable for you, and made river to run through it, and made rawasi, mountains, okay, to stabilize the earth. And He make a partition between the two seas, okay. He say, is there other God beside Allah? What we can say about it? He's the only one. I say, I did all these things. Say, what about the one who answer? The one who disturb, in disturbance, in hardship. I am the one who answer His call, okay? Who is the one that guide you in the darkness of the ocean? And also when you are in the land, the one who sends the rains, the one who sends all the things as a rahmah from Him, mercy. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Let's assume that somebody will stand and say, yes, I did this. So here Allah saying in the end of the verse, what? Bring your evidence if you truthful about your claim. And this is Surah 27, verse 61, 62, 63. In Surah At-Tur, Allah gave a serious challenge. Surah At-Tur 35, verse number 36. أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. They've been created without anything, or they are the creator. So that means you are a creator or you've been created. Okay? Did you create yourself? No. Are you the creator? No. So there is one say, I am the creator. So you better submit and accept it. You see? Because you could not. And if you're going to talk about it, so Allah say what? Bring your evidence. This is it. See, subhanAllah. Allah giving the people fair trial and fair chance. Okay. If you think you did it, bring your evidence. Do something. Like we talked before about the verse that talk about the fly. Okay? And Allah challenge everyone to create a fly, not an elephant, a fly. Did anybody create a fly yet? And never anybody going to be create a fly. So Allah say, are you the creator? Can you say yes? Okay. Did you create yourself? You came out of nothing? Right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, did he create the heaven and the earth? Who can claim? Russia? China? America? No. We see in Surah Al-Isra, what is this? 17. وَقَالُوا أَإِذَا كُنَّا عِظَامًا وَرُفَاتًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُثُونَ أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُثُونَ خَلْقًا جَدِيدًا قُلْ كُونُوا حِجَارَةً أَوْ حَدِيدًا أَوْ خَلْقًا مِمَّا يَكْبُرُ فِي صُدُورِكُمْ فَسَأَقُولُونَ مَنْ يُعِيدُنَا قُلِ الَّذِي فَطَرَكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةً. They say, how after we turn to dirt, these bones became ruined and symbol with the dirt, okay? We're going to be recreated. We're going to be resurrected after this. So Allah is saying what? So be metal or rocks or any other substance that's so great and so strong in your eyes. You could not see the possibility that Allah is capable to bring you back again. Okay. You worry about you made out of flesh and bones and all these things? Okay, what you want to be? Even if you are made out of the metal or rock, something more stronger than bones, okay? Or anything from your imagination that is so great that Allah could not revive it again, all right? They will say, who's the one who going to revive us after this? Say to them, O Muhammad, the one who had created you the first time. Simple like this. Okay? So we see how Islam talked to us. How Islam given proof and physical things. Okay? Not want you to close your eyes and believe. No, he's given you a clear evidence. And it make you put your hand, okay, in the evidence. They see it with your own eyes. And you can think about it and reflect it. And after this, if you want to argue with it, Islam is open for the debate. Okay? Bring your evidence if you are truthful. So, subhanAllah, we should be so grateful and thankful that Allah given us something and He opened the challenge if we want to make a challenge. But you can make the challenge and you are not going to go too far. You have nothing other than you have to accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to say Raditu billahi rabban wa bil islami deena. I submit and I surrender. Okay? And I'm pleased with Allah to be the Lord and Islam that way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll stop here this morning inshallah. If anybody have any question or any comments, inshallah we'll continue this series that we can get to know more about the beauty of Islam and the greatness of Islam. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. And inshallah we close this chapter and we start community discussion for anybody who may have anything to discuss. And I think we have something from last week. You can close that.
I got a quick question. When you said Islam declared war on showing off.
Or showing off.
Yeah.
That means Islam against this.
Is that limited to showing off during the act of ibadah?
Showing off in your heart. You meant to do it.
Yeah, I mean, like, let's say I'm playing basketball and I'm showing off. Like dribbling everybody.
No. You're doing
show off.
Okay, this is showing off. Mean showing off, seeking recognition of the people in things which is supposed to be. Doing it to get closer to Allah. You understand? Not I'm showing how good I am in the basketball, try to win the game or something like this, or I'm wrestling. Okay? This is fine. And you need to show that you're capable to knock this other person down and to win the game or whatever it is. But we're talking about, you understand, and instead of seeking the pleasure of Allah with your prayer, with your sadaqah, now you're doing it so the people can acknowledge you and talk good about you and say he's a good man, he's a pious man, he's a true believer. You understand? We're talking about the things of ibadah, things that's supposed to be only done for the sake of Allah. Alhamdulillah. We have was a project from last week.